So normally in a farmer's field, pollination occurs naturally. In the case of maize, each pollen will tassel will produce millions of pollen grains, and the magic of pollination happens without human intervention. But when geneticists and breeders want to do research, we need to know the parentage of the seed, and so we make manual pollination where we control the pollen from the tassel to the silk of choice. The corn plant is a cross-pollinating species. It has two parts. The tassel contains the male, and the tassel contains these little pollen sacs on the top. You can see these little fringes hanging out. They contain pollen, and the wind can blow the pollen around anywhere from dropping the pollen on the same plant to half a mile away. The silks are the female part, and they have little tiny hairs that collect the pollen. And so when we make these pollinations, we want to control what pollen lands on the silk. The very first step in making controlled pollinations is to prevent unwanted pollinations on the ear. When an ear is developing, there is initially at the leaf axil, where the leaf connects to the stalk, a tiny little ear shoot that is growing over time. And before the silks emerge, we need to put a shoot bag on the shoot before the silks emerge, and that prevents unwanted pollinations. And so we shoot bag every single day as our first thing. Then as the plant develops over time, we can determine whether we're ready to make a pollination or not. So on the first day of making an actual pollination, you need to look for the tassel to see whether there's pollen available. And then when there's pollen, then you know you can make pollinations. Then you also have to look at the recipient female to see if the silks are available. And when you know that you have tassel and silk ready for that day, then you can set up a pollination. Setting up involves putting a tassel bag on the tassel to collect the pollen. Pollen can live for approximately 2 to 4 hours, maybe longer. And so there's pollen from neighboring plants from maybe up to half a mile away on any given plant part. So on day one, we cover up the tassel bag so that overnight all pollen dies. And the next day, the only pollen that's living in the bag is from that tassel. When we cut back the silks, we are ensuring that we are accessing as many silks as possible at any given point in time. The very first day when silks emerge, maybe perhaps 5 or 10 or 30 silks will emerge. And if we pollinate at that point in time, we will only get 30 kernels. One silk, one kernel. So what we can do is cut back into the ear, and we encounter more and more silks. When we cut back, we may access 100 through 200, 300 silks. And tomorrow when we make our pollination, that will result in 300 kernels. On day two, we will return to our plants of interest and we will take the tassel down. This process is called taking down. We will take the tassel bag down. Oftentimes we will shake the pollen, the tassel in the bag. That will release all the pollen from those anthers, the pollen sacs. And the only pollen that's alive in the bag will be from that tassel and not any neighboring plants. We'll take that pollen onto the recipient plant, and we will then lift up the shoot bag, pour the pollen onto the silks, and that will result in our pollination. In maize, there are two main types of pollinations we make. One is called self-pollination, where we take the pollen from one plant and we put it onto the ear of that same plant. So we're pollinating itself, and that results in inbreeding and self-pollination. The other type of pollination is called cross-pollination, where we take pollen from one plant and put it on another plant. And in both cases, we're making seed for specific research purposes, to answer very specific research questions. But in order to make those pollinations, those crosses, that seed, we have to know what pollen is going on to itself.